Hello my friends, it's time to unbox some new phones today. Samsung launched the Galaxy J6 Plus and the Galaxy J4 Plus a couple of days back. Both the phones are now available in Pakistan. These phones come with very interesting specifications and they do have an impressive price point as well. Both the Galaxy J6 and J4 Plus come with the Infinity displays. Samsung has revamped the design of these smartphones. The Galaxy J6 Plus comes with a fingerprint scanner mounted on the side. The power button actually works as a fingerprint scanner. If you have ever used a Sony Xperia smartphone, you will definitely know how this fingerprint scanner works. Both the Galaxy J6 Plus and J4 Plus are powered by a similar SoC and GPU. However, there is a difference in the camera and storage department on these phones. Let's go ahead and unbox these phones to see what the South Korean phone maker has come up with. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon. My name is Usama, welcome to my YouTube channel. Let's start the unboxing now. So I have both the phones, the Galaxy J4 Plus and the Galaxy J6 Plus lying in front of the camera. Since the Galaxy J Plus is a little more interesting smartphone, so I would like to unbox this phone first of all. We have this cover which has the Galaxy J6 Plus box packed inside. The cover states that it has a 6.0-inch Infinity Display dual camera and a side fingerprint scanner. This side fingerprint scanner is actually the highlight of this smartphone. Let's try to take off the wrappers from this box and see what it has to offer. Okay, so the wrappers are coming off now. At the back, this phone has its warranty card with the Samsung membership card. I don't know what this membership card is all about, but I'm definitely going to take a look at it later on. For now, we have to see what the South Korean phone maker has to offer with the Galaxy J6 Plus. Let's get the phone out of this box now. I will open the box. It's a 32GB variant as the box clearly mentions it. So let's take a look at the phone. This is the all new Samsung Galaxy J6 Plus. At the top we have some IMEI speakers which we are not going to need at the moment. The phone, as you can see, is in the black color. Right when you get the phone out of the box, you can see and feel that it's a very premium device. Below this layer we have got the silicone case, which is actually a nice addition since it is very difficult to find a case for a brand new smartphone. And there we have the power adapter, which definitely doesn't support fast charging. You are not going to be able to charge your phone from 0 to 100 within an hour. Here is the typical hand free that Samsung adds to every single Galaxy J device out there. And here is the power cord to connect your phone to the computer or connect it to the charger. I am very much interested in the fingerprint reader of this phone. Before doing so, let's take a look at what's written on the box. The box states Infinity Display, Dual Camera, Fingerprint Scanner, 13MP plus 5MP shooter at the back, 8MP shooter on the front, 3GB RAM, 32GB internal storage, and there are some other tech specs written on this box. That's pretty much it with the box of the Galaxy J6 Plus. Let's go ahead and try turning this phone on now. It's time to turn the phone on. To turn on the phone, I'll have to take the wrappers off. However, I have already pressed the power button. I will simply pull these wrappers off now and wait for this phone to turn on. The highlighted feature here is only the fingerprint reader, which is mounted on the right side. If you have ever used a Sony Xperia smartphones, you will know that how it works. And there is that fingerprint reader on the right side. On the left we have the volume rockers and SIM card and memory card slots. The phone is turning on now. This phone has got the dual shooter setup at the back, as you can see it. It's going to take a while for this phone to turn on. In the meanwhile, we will go ahead and unbox our Galaxy J4. Let's go ahead, unbox a Galaxy J4 and compare these devices once we are done with the unboxing and we have set up these devices as well. This is the low-end smartphone, the Galaxy J4 Plus, with a packing very much similar to the Galaxy J6 Plus. The cover placed on the top of the box states that this phone also has a 6.0-inch Infinity display. At the back, we have this tagline saying more than you expected. Let's see what is packed inside that is more than what we expected on this phone. Let's pull the box of this phone out of this cover. Here is the Galaxy J4 Plus box coming out of its case. The box mentions that this is a 16GB variant, which means that this phone has a RAM of 2GB. And I will go ahead and take the wrapper off from the phone in order to get my hands on the unit. The wrappers are coming off. This is the Galaxy J4 Plus's box with the warranty cards at the back, and there is a Samsung members card. What Samsung has mentioned at the back of this box, it also says that infinity display, 13MP camera at the back, 5MP camera on the front, LED front flash, 4G LTE, 1.4G quad core CPU, 152.6mm 6.0 HD Plus display, 13MP rear camera, 5MP front camera, 16GB memory, and as I mentioned earlier, it has a RAM of 2GB. That's all mentioned at the back of this box. It's time to get the phone out. I will have to cut off these last two speakers to get my hands on the phone. Looks like I will have to take this phone out from the other side. It's not going to come out from this side. Yes, this is the proper way to get it out. Here is the Galaxy J4 Plus in the golden color. These are the IMEI stickers that we definitely don't need at the moment. This is the Galaxy J4 Plus. And the speaker pasted atop also states about the infinity display and the camera and LED front flash of this phone. I will turn it on. In the meanwhile, let's check out the other contents of the Galaxy J4 Plus's box. Here is a quick start guide, and surprisingly, there is no silicone case for this phone, which I really don't like, because there is a silicone case in the box of the Galaxy J6 Plus. These are the usual headphones. There is a power adapter, and this is a power cord to connect your phone to the computer or charge it. But these phones do not support any kind of fast charging, so you are going to have to wait for a couple of hours in order to charge your phone from 0 to 100%. Let's check out this device. I really like this golden color because it's not as golden as it used to be on the previous Samsung Galaxy J series smartphones. Let's check out the display of this phone by taking this wrapper off. This is a 6.0-inch IPS LCD display. I really like the placement of the front camera and the LED flash. On the left side, you can see that the front camera shooter is there, and on the right side we have the LED flash. Okay, so on the left side we have the volume rockers, the SIM card tray and the micro SD card and second SIM card tray. On the right side we have this power button to turn this phone on. There is no fingerprint scanner on this phone. There is no rear fingerprint scanner or front fingerprint scanner. At the bottom we have the USB Type-A connection port, and a 3.5mm headphone jack. That's pretty much it about the Galaxy J4 Plus. It's time to compare the Galaxy J4 Plus with the Galaxy J6 Plus. Let's go ahead and find the key differences between both these smartphones now. At this point, I have set up both these smartphones using my Google Play account. It's time to check out the side fingerprint scanner on the Galaxy J6 Plus. I'm going to set it up using a temporary pin. Let's see how it comes along. I will add a temporary pin and set up the fingerprint scanner by registering my thumb. It should be noted here that this fingerprint scanner is not as efficient as it is on the traditional fingerprint scanners on the previous Galaxy handsets. It's really, really hard to register your thumb on this fingerprint scanner since it's very thin. It's time to test the fingerprint scanner on the Galaxy J6 Plus. I've been trying to unlock the phone using this fingerprint scanner for quite a while, and it turns out that this is not the best solution that Samsung has come up with. This fingerprint scanner does get stuck in between, so I am not definitely liking this side-mounted fingerprint scanner here. It rarely works. These phones have got the facial recognition as well, but I believe that facial recognition is not going to work as good as it works on the flagship devices. These are both the phones from the rear. Both these phones have got a glass back, which means these are prone to fingerprint and all the other spots that these devices can attract. The main difference is between the cameras. Galaxy J6 Plus has dual cameras at the back and the Galaxy J4 Plus has a single camera at the back. The other difference between these phones is in the storage department. Galaxy J4 Plus has a 16GB internal storage and the Galaxy J6 Plus has a 32GB internal storage. The J4 Plus has a 2GB RAM and the J6 Plus has a 3GB of RAM inside. Both these phones use the same SoC, which is the Qualcomm Snapdragon 425 accompanied by Adreno 308 GPU. Both these phones run on Android Oreo out of the box, which means you are going to get the Project Rebel support as well. It means that you are going to get the future updates quite early, since Google enforces the Project Rebel on all the Android phones launching with the Android 8.0 Oreo on board. Let's take a look at the SIM eject tool and eject the SIM trays of both these devices to see how the dual SIM and the SD card mechanism works on these phones. Let's pull the SIM tray of the Galaxy J4 Plus out. This is the nano SIM card tray, and next to this tray there is another tray which can be used for the micro SD card and the second SIM card. Let's do the same with the Galaxy J6 Plus as well. The Galaxy J6 Plus has the same SIM slot setup as well. This is the nano SIM card tray, and next to it we have the micro SD and second SIM card tray. And these devices are set up and all good to run. If we talk about the price of these devices, you can find the Galaxy J6 Plus for around 27,000 rupees in Pakistan and the Galaxy J4 Plus for around 23,000 rupees in Pakistan. Both these devices are available in the market. The Galaxy J6 Plus is available in three different colors, including the black, red and the silver color, while the Galaxy J4 Plus is available in black, gold, pink and blue colors. That's it for now. I will go ahead and compare the camera of both these devices. I will attach the camera samples at the end of this video so that you can decide the winner for yourself. There is a clear difference between the cameras of these devices. The camera shooters are completely different from each other. Take a look at these pictures and find the best results for yourself. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. I will see you on another day with another unboxing video. Stay blessed.